I will fully admit that nothing makes me as salty as a Shell Smash Cloyster sweeping my team. Shell Smash is arguably the best setup move in the entire game, raising your Pokemon's attack, special attack, and speed by two stages apiece. For reference's sake, this is like two Dragon Dances in a row, which by itself is one of the best setup moves in the entire game. One of Terrakion's best sets is called a Double Dance set, where he uses Swords Dance and then Rock Polish to just completely destroy his opponents. This move does that with one less move slot and one less turn. Caveat, of course, is that Shell Smash also lowers the Pokemon's defense and special defense by one stage, making them a little bit frail. But this pairs well with Cloyster's naturally amazing physical bulk, well enough that he can usually live at least one physical hit. Cloyster also brings its amazing ability Skill Link to the table. So this guarantees any multi-hit move that ranges from 2 to 5 hits like Fury Attack, for example, or in this case, a Stab Icicle Spear, hits all 5 every single time. So between Icicle Spear and Rock Blast, Cloyster has 2 different moves with 125 base power, not to mention Ice Shard to help shore up his weaknesses against priority moves like Vacuum Wave or Mach Punch or Extreme Speed. Normally, these Cloysters choose between a White Earth, which mitigates the defense and special defense drop, which once again ensures that Cloyster's great defenses are completely unimpeded, or a Focus Sash, which means that you have to get an attack off on this thing twice in order to kill it. This helps against priority moves, of course, or it means that you can set up right in front of someone that would ordinarily one-shot you and kill you, and still get the boost off, and then sweep them afterwards. However, skyrocketing in popularity this gen is King's Rock, which takes my salt levels from 2 bags of kosher to a Lake Huron salt mine. King's Rock grants any of your Pokemon's regular moves a 10% chance to flinch, which is pretty cheesy and almost never really a recommended item. However, on multi-hit moves like Icicle Spear or Power Trip, the 10% stacks a little bit with every hit. Personally, I don't know quite the math because it's not an exact stacking, but with a 5-hit move, it works out to a 41% chance to flinch, all told, which is insane. I mean, 30% flinch chance on Iron Head makes it amazing on top of its base power. If you increase the damage of that by 50% and increase the flinch rate by 1/3, so 41%, it becomes unstoppable and one of the best attacking moves in the entire game. So yes, despite the advice I'm about to give you, even if you have a huge hard counter to Cloyster, like physically defensive Bronzong, I mean, you could theoretically get flinched down like 20 times and still die before getting off a hit. It's absurd. So yes, this thing is insane. Easily one of the most threatening setup sweepers in the game once it gets a chance to set up. Normally, Cloyster is kind of regulated to low ladder cheese in previous gens, but due to the infancy of this generation's meta, or I guess you could say even the nature of its most popular defensive course, it's seeing a lot of usage and play even on higher ladder. But that's enough gassing it up for now. Let's talk about how to actually beat Cloyster. Generally speaking, one of the better counters to Cloyster is always going to be a defensive steel type, without a secondary typing that makes it weak to Icicle Spear. So, like Ferrothorn or Corviknight have. Same goes for bulky water types, especially if you can get one that also resists the Rock Blast. This is actually a huge reason why Cloyster wasn't as good in previous generations. The main steel types weren't just Ferrothorn and Corviknight, but also Heatran, Lagirna, Mega Scizor, Tapu Fini, Mega Titar. Keldeo and Jirachi were also very relevant in those previous metas, and they're not seeing too much love this gen right now, but that might begin to change after Dugtrio's absence starts to shake things up a little bit. So yeah, keep an eye on Pokemon like this that fit that description if you want like an actual hard defensive counter to him. Even in underused right now, there's actually even more candidates to wall him than underused. Once again, mostly due to typing in my opinion. Because, you know, you can just take a Bronzong, for example, throw some Fizz Def on him, and boom, he can eat 3 Icicle Spears for breakfast. It's also worth noting, for any of these Pokemon that wall Cloyster, that a special attack will have a much easier time killing him. Like I said earlier, his physical defense is pretty bonkers, even with Shell Smash's defense drop. So to go back to that Bronzong, a pretty beefy Gyro Ball, for example, is only going to hit him for 42-55%, while an uninvested Psychic is going to range from 92-109% of a Cloyster's health. Another good way to beat Cloyster is with a strong priority user, like Conquilter's Mach Punch. However, Cloyster does have his own priority move in Ice Shard, so you want to make sure you can use someone who has enough health to take the hit, but also isn't weak to ice moves. Some other good, you know, kind of fringe answers to keep in mind, if you can't kill him outright, you can taunt the Cloyster before he can Shell Smash, which is obviously great. Same goes for phasing him out with a Whirlwind or a Roar right after he sets up. In a similar vein, tricking him a Choice Locking item or Encoring a Cloyster who's setting up is a great way to prevent the setup. Stealth Rocks in general are extremely useful. They cut his health by 25% on every swap in. That can't be understated either. It's also important that you're smart with your sacks when playing against Cloyster. Oftentimes, when he sets up on you, it's easy to just panic and switch around and let your whole team get bodied. But if you can take the time to determine which of your team is the least important when it comes to actually beating your opponent, it will pay off. Incineroar and Arcanine can actually be really useful in this specific scenario, because you can swap them into an Icicle Sphere, lower their attack with Intimidate so you don't take too much damage, and then set up this interesting 50-50, where you can either swap out so you can get off another Intimidate at another time into someone who can eat the Rock Blast very easily, or stay in and Flare Blitz in case they overpredict and go for another Icicle Spear or another Shell Smash. Some other Pokemon who do very well are Scarf Ditto, of course, who can copy the opponent's stat changes and still be faster with a Choice Scarf. Also, Galarian Weezing has a pretty cool matchup. Beyond being a really beefy physical tank in its own right, Neutralizing Gas disables Cloyster's Skill Link ability. So you can often swap in on like two Icicle Spear hits and then Strange Team him afterwards for the kill. But really, despite all of that sort of miscellaneous matchup info, there's really only one piece of advice you need to keep in mind when you're playing versus a Cloyster. It's a very important idea, even beyond Cloyster, and that's the idea of not letting your opponent set up for free. When you're playing against a Cloyster, you need to constantly keep in mind, what if he swaps in this turn and Shell Smashes? So next time you're going to defog against that Dragapult that you all, think to yourself, what if Cloyster swaps in this turn? Then what do I do? Well, I was going to Stealth Rock there, but what if he Shell Smashes there instead? Well, I was going to Rapid Swim, but what if he Shell Smashes there? This thinking in general favors thinking a few turns ahead instead of the turn immediately in front of you. I think it's easy for lower to mid-level players to get caught in this trap of only thinking of what the best turn is, this immediate turn. So what's the best thing I can do this turn? What's the best thing I can do this turn? And then this turn and this turn until the game's over. Instead of constantly forming this evolving game plan that changes and shifts and evolves as the game itself does. And Cloyster is a Pokemon that punishes this one turn at a time thinking harder than almost anyone else. In fact, try thinking ahead and anticipating any setup sweeper who can do well versus your team. See if you can strangle its setup opportunities with clever switches and move selection. Soon, you can turn your opponent's best win condition into an empty move slot for them. Because if it doesn't get a good chance to set up, that thing is next to useless. So next time you wade into the Badlands known as the OU Ladder, keep those tips in mind and send a few Cloysters straight to the depths of hell where they belong. That's gonna do it for this one though. Thank you guys for watching and take it easy.